We were arrested on charges of inciting violence against the police, and clearly anybody with working eyes can see that we were not inciting violence, but instead protecting our homes. What happened is that the Israeli authorities, the Israeli occupation authorities, are trying to intimidate us, are trying to terrorize us. And this is not just happening to us, it's happening to thousands of Palestinians across colonized Palestine who are getting arrested. Just today, two 17-year-olds were arrested from Sheikh Jarrah. This is a tactic of instilling fear in Palestinians who refuse to be ethnically cleansed, who refuse to be violated by the Israeli occupation courts. But we will not be intimidated, obviously. Well, just to be accurate, they're not security forces. This is an internationally recognized occupation. So they are occupation forces that are illegally present in our neighborhoods. And they're not keeping anybody secure. And they're not defending anybody. And of course, they have us locked down. And we're worried about this is certainly not going to be the first time we get detained. We are anticipating more and more. I even had to sign on a bail that declared that I will be called into questioning more times. We are waiting. We don't know what they have in their pockets, but we know that we're not doing anything that's illegal, and that we know that their presence under international law is within itself illegal, and that their presence in our neighborhoods is what is incitement of violence. There's a lot of partnership, I would say, between the settlers, who are mostly armed, and the Israeli occupation forces. The ones who are committing the violence are both of these parties, oftentimes together. We saw in Hebron a few days ago a man be beaten up severely by the Israeli forces, and then have the settlers protect the Israeli forces and prevent any medics from reaching him.